Chestika Novo Godina. Happy New Year from a snow-covered Bulgaria. I'm on the south bank of the Danube in Novo Celo, in the northwest corner of Bulgaria. We're close to the border with Serbia, and across the river is Romania. Known in history as one of the long-standing frontiers of the Roman Empire, the Danube forms borders with 10 countries. It originates in the Black Forest in Germany and flows eastwards to the Black Sea. Many British people have bought property in Bulgaria over recent years, but mainly on the Black Sea coast in the east. But there are small pockets of Brits in this area, even though it seems to be a geographical and economical backwater. This winter weather adds to the gloomy picture of dereliction with these empty factories throughout the whole of the Vidin region. This area was once the breadbasket of Eastern Europe, but now the workforce has left to find jobs in Western Europe and Russia. The decline came as the Iron Curtain fell, which marked the end of communism. Bulgaria joined the EU 2 years ago, but now with rampant world recession, it will be a long, slow step-by-step process to recovery. To find out more, I met up with my good friend and neighbour Valentin outside the children's home, who told me more about the last 20 years.
The reason for what this area, for the last 20 years, the economic of the area is not going very well, because before the communist regime is go away, is finished, the area is a mostly agricultural area. We made in this area a lot of corn, a lot of fruits, a lot of vegetables, grape, wine, and we export this for the other countries. But after the democracy, the people lose the market on the Arabian countries or on the countries on the East Europe, what is important.
Thank you very much, Valentin. We're now going into the children's home, where we're going to talk to Mick Cooper and Angelica, the director. To our surprise, we were given a very warm welcome by the children, with a performance that lasted nearly half an hour, with lots of Bulgarian children's songs, rhymes and poetry. We also had a chance to look around the home, with particular interest in the kitchen, before we met up with Angelica.
Could you tell us a little bit about the children's home? How many children, what age they are, what are the prospects for them, and when do they ask to leave the children's home?
Angelica has been the director of the children's home for 9 months and sees the children and staff as one big family. She is trying everything possible to improve their lives. Approximately 40 children between the ages of 5 and 21 live in this orphanage. Last year, funding for the orphanage was transferred to social services and now comes under the municipality. The mayor has a much smaller budget for them than previously. Angelica is in the process of applying for EU money, but it is a convoluted and drawn-out business, especially with such a broad age range. The needs of a 5-year-old are very different to those of a 14-year-old. The job prospects in this area are limited, many being short-term and seasonal, mainly casual and often paid daily. The chef school is a good opportunity for these young people, and properly presented will give them a lifelong skill. This will offer an interesting new subject that hasn't previously been on the timetable and will help keep students in the local area living and working. Angelica says all offers of help are welcome. Yeah, we...